sugar cubes are blocky with sharp corners. But if I put 10 sugar cubes into a thermos and shake them for a few minutes, they start to change shape. All of the motion of them bumping into each other at the sides of the container causes pieces to break off. And after enough shaking, I end up with sugar spheres instead of sugar cubes. And at the bottom of my thermos, I have a layer of powder. In this simple activity, small pieces of sugar broke off from a cube because I was shaking them like crazy. But in geology, heat, water, wind, and freezing temperatures all cause rocks to break into smaller pieces. Those smaller pieces then move to new locations, and this process wears down mountains, carves canyons, it builds beaches and floodplains. It literally shapes the Earth. I'm Science Mom.
And I'm Math Dad.
And today, we're going to be making a big mess.
What? Haha. So Science Mom is kidding about the mess, right, Science Mom?
I'm actually not.
Oh,
I want to ask real fast for those who are watching live in the chat, do you hear a lot of noise besides me talking? Because there's some construction work happening outside. I'm really hoping that it's not too noisy and that our directional mic is kind of filtering some of that out. But let us know how the audio is. So real quick, I want to give a shout out to Olivia watching in Minnesota, Matthew from Massachusetts, and Josh, Abby, and Mabel watching in Scotland. Welcome, you guys. Today we are going to be talking about weathering and erosion. And in the example that we started with, you guys could see that if you take sugar cubes, shake them up, they become round. And this is why rocks in a river are round. Have you ever noticed that, Math Dad?
I have totally noticed that. They're smooth and they're really cool river rocks.
Oh, and thank you, the Turks and Isaac and Nelson, everyone's saying noisy and loud.
We're sorry about that. Somebody is working right on the other side of our wall. And they had to time it just right now.
So
just wrong now.
Yeah. It is bad timing. Let's do our demonstration first, because this one we don't need quite as much audio.
All right. What's our demonstration, Science Mom?
We're gonna have a contest to see who can build a canyon first.
Oh.
So I have a tray of mud here, and I've got a cup for you and a cup for me.
Well, one of the three of us was drinking from one of these cups right before. I won't tell you which of the three of us it was.
It was Science Puppy. But don't worry, we have extra cups.
All right.
So here you go, Math Dad. Let's switch our view. And we are going to see if we can make a canyon just by pouring down the sides here.
Okay.
So I made a tiny little groove.
We're trying to make a canyon.
We're trying to make a canyon. I made a little groove here, a little groove here. But your side has some extra aquarium rocks.
Okay.
So pour nice and slow and steady.
All right. Come on, canyon. Come on. Oh, I washed a rock away.
You did wash a rock away, but my canyon is growing a little bit faster because I do not have as many rocks.
What? Come on. Come on. Canyon. Ooh, I'm getting like two canyons. They're splitting around the rocks.
Ooh.
It's kind of the effect I'm noticing.
Now, in real life, this is exactly what happens when rain falls on mountains. Little grooves start to have more erosion and you get canyons forming.
Ooh, but okay, if the contest was for the best canyon, you definitely have the bigger canyon.
This one goes all the way down to our base layer pretty quickly. Yours didn't quite make it all the way down to the base layer, but that's because these pieces are bigger. So let's go right up here and talk just a little bit about size. Oh, you guys, I am so sorry about the noise. This is really rather unfortunate. Yep. One of the disadvantages of live streaming is that if someone decides to do a construction project right by your house when you're live streaming, you're stuck. Oh, my goodness.
Yep.
The bigger the rock, the harder it is to get to move. So this big pebble is really big compared to this tiny little piece of sand. And since all I had on my side was sand, that meant that the water could move it. And water is not the only thing that can cause erosion.
So that you're saying that the water moved the smaller pebbles just because they're lighter, they're easier to move, but
they're
the bigger pebbles are not going to move as easily, and that's why you had better erosion than I did.
Exactly. Let's pull up the notes real fast. We're going to go to page 69. And if you're distracted by the noise, don't worry. Science Puppy is too.
His heart's beating really fast. All right, so.
Oh my goodness. This is horrible, you guys. I'm so sorry.
All right, so it says erosion. Ooh, and look at this. That's kind of clever. The N is eroding away. I see what you did there, Science Mom.
The N is eroding away. Now, there are three words, three cool science words we're going to learn today.
It says page 68 in the notes.
Weathering, erosion, and deposition.
Oh, yeah.
Weathering is when things break apart. So when we were shaking that tumbler and it had sugar cubes in it and you had pieces breaking off, that was weathering. And when sometimes when people say erosion, what they really mean is weathering.
Ooh, I think I might misuse that word sometimes. Yeah.
Yeah. So if something is breaking apart, a big rock is breaking into smaller pieces, that is weathering. And then when those small pieces move, that is erosion. And for anyone who came in late and was asking in the chat what the noise is, there's a construction project happening right outside our house. And we apologize for the noise.
So that's something breaking off a cube.
Yeah.
It's brilliant.
It's a good job, Math Dad. Nicely done.
All right.
And then erosion is when those small pieces, which we call sediment, when they move somewhere else. So in the bottom of our jar, after we shook the sugar cubes, we could see a lot of little tiny pieces of sugar, and that was sediment. And if we dump those pieces of sugar out, then that is erosion. That's those pieces moving. And rivers are a great way for sediment to move. They carry along. We're going to talk about a couple different examples of erosion and weathering, but water and wind are the best.
And the last one?
The last one is deposition. So let's take a look real quick at our little contained mess where I was making a river. And you can see that sediment is washing down this slope. But what is happening when it gets to this area right down here?
Oh, it's kind of pooling at the bottom.
It is. It's pooling at the bottom. This is a delta. When you have a river flowing down a slope, once the river gets to somewhere where it's not moving as fast, the sediment gets dropped or deposited. And that is our third step, deposition, where the sediment ends up.
So I drew that as a little... all the particles together.
Piling up together. So Louisiana, shout out to anyone who lives in the state of Louisiana or has visited there, you'll notice it's shaped kind of like a boot.
Right.
That boot at the bottom of Louisiana that goes out, that's all formed from the Mississippi River Delta.
So that's just stuff that has been deposited.
Yes.
The deposition word, okay.
Deposited.
Okay, so let me see if I got this right. When things are breaking off, that's the weathering. When they're being carried,
That's
the erosion. And when they're being dropped and settling, that's the deposition.
Exactly right. And this happens to rocks and to landforms all over the world all the time. And the world around us is always changing. Beaches are being either washed away and weathered away, eroded away, or they're being deposited. Sometimes you'll get a beach where there wasn't a beach before because the sand gets dropped there. Same thing with the sand dune.
Oh, that's pretty cool. What about something like a cave? Is that erosion?
There are different types of erosion. Let's go back at the notes real quick, and I want to point out that sometimes these things are just mechanical. That means it's just things bumping into each other, or ice, when it expands, it can crack a sidewalk.
Ooh, I've seen that. Or potholes in the road.
Yes.
Go bump, bump.
And this is called frost wedging. This is a really important part of how weathering happens, because when water freezes into ice, it has a lot of force and it will actually break pieces apart. But sometimes it can be chemical reactions. So if you've ever seen the dark brown staining on rocks in the desert, that's actually a chemical reaction. And caves can be formed. They're chemical reactions that happen that dissolve out limestone and change the rock inside a cave.
Anders asks, would dropping a rock be deposition? So if we're depositing the rock somewhere, we're...
Technically,
yeah,
yes.
Okay.
Yes, technically, yes. Now, our class is going to be just a little bit shorter today because of this noise and this sound issue. But before we go to our chem mystery, I want to bring up an excellent correction from yesterday's quiz that Finn had. Oh. So yesterday we had the question, do all volcanoes produce lava? And is that true or false?
And I said false.
And what we should have said is, do all volcanoes produce lava flows?
Oh.
So do all volcanoes make a lava flow? No, because we have pyroclastic explosions that produce clouds of ash. And Finn pointed out, if a pyroclastic explosion produces a cloud of ash, that's still pieces of lava, but they're just really, really small pieces.
Ah. Oh
my goodness. I really liked that correction. So thank you, Finn. Okay, super fast. We are going to do our chem, not our chem mystery, our where in the world mystery. How about it's time for polls? Because you guys can still participate in the polls, even if it is super, super noisy. Oh my goodness. I think we may have to replace this live stream later on, you guys. This is really embarrassing.
All right. So let's go to itempool.com/sciencemom/live. I can do this.
We have a couple questions for you guys. And then we're going to end a little bit early today just because of this crazy, crazy noise from the construction project. Our apologies, you guys.
Uh-oh. Trying to figure out what's wrong.
Item pool is mad that it's so noisy, Math Dad. I'm surprised you didn't know that.
Maybe it's not. Oh, I usually have a minute to fiddle with this.
Well, we do have a birthday shout out today. So special birthday shout out to Cedric from Ottawa, Canada, who turns 12 today. Happy birthday, Cedric. You doing all right, Math Dad?
I'm not getting the item pool overlay to work.
Oh, no. You know what? Maybe what we should do is...
We'll pull it up on this other computer.
Okay.
It'll work.
We'll pull it up on the other computer. While Math Dad is pulling that up, I do have to share some very exciting news. So today we had some unexpected uh-oh news. That was the construction project right next door that started as soon as we went live. But we also have some very happy news. Math Dad and I saw that there was an announcement of some extra vaccines, and we drove all the way in super early this morning and stood in line, and they gave us a number and told us to come back in the afternoon, and there's a chance that if they have enough extras, we might be able to get the COVID vaccine. We were super excited about that.
No kidding.
So cross your fingers for us. And
still trying to do it. But
still trying to do it.
Oh, I'm getting close.
You can do it, Math Dad. We just need to switch our camera view now. There we go.
All right. So we see our first question here. All right. So when rocks are broken down into smaller pieces, this is called, is it weathering, erosion, or deposition? When rocks are broken down into smaller pieces, what do we call that? Ooh, boy.
We definitely have a winner.
Ooh, I don't know. Okay. This could be the one I trick them on, Science Mom.
I don't think it's going to be the one you trick them on.
It's a tricky one. No? What do you think, Kaladin?
Kaladin's like, I think there are people outside our house and it's noisy. He was growling up a storm earlier, but then if we hold him, he doesn't growl because he's like, oh, I'm safe. So that's why he is here with us all day.
All right, we're going to finish up. And
weathering is correct. Good job.
So this one is tricky because the word erosion often gets misused or gets used in place of the word weathering.
Yes.
in the common speak, but that's actually the weathering that's the breaking.
Yep. When rocks are broken into smaller pieces, when you have sand being created by friction against a rock, that is weathering. Our next question is, the faster water moves,
ooh,
is it the smaller piece of sediment it can carry or the larger?
Okay, so as water moves faster,
can it carry bigger or smaller pieces?
I think they'll be able to get this one. But yeah, that was interesting. So thinking back to our demo today, it wasn't obvious to me what was going to happen. Okay.
And you can kind of think about rivers and floods. When a river floods, do you have bigger pieces or smaller pieces that are flowing?
One of those. All right. Let's see how they did.
Going to finish and reveal. The larger piece is correct.
Yeah, so the only way you could move a larger rock is to have more force behind it, and that's what this faster moving water can do. Question 3. When sediment is moved from one place to another, this is called weathering, erosion, or deposition.
Which one?
So, fun fact, if I remember right, the word deposition had more than one meaning. So remember how when if we talk about changes of matter, we've got things like melting, when something goes from a solid to a liquid. But if something goes from a gas to a solid,
sometimes that can be called deposition. Desublimation.
Desublimation or deposition. So it's a word that gets used in multiple contexts here. All right. Ooh.
Erosion is correct. Very nice.
Do you see how I tried to trick them by talking about deposition?
That was pretty sneaky math.
I tricked 37 people out of 57.
But you didn't trick everybody. Okay. So, right. No victory point for you.
Not bad. Not bad, guys. All right. How does freezing water cause rocks to weather? Ooh, we didn't talk about this much.
We talked about this just a little bit.
Just briefly. They couldn't hear you, though, because it was so noisy.
It is really noisy.
So does it hold them in place? Does it make them so cold that they crack? Or does the liquid water in the cracks expand when it freezes? One of those explains how freezing water causes rocks to weather.
And this noise, you guys. Oh my goodness, I can't believe it. I did not expect this construction project to be so loud. And the science kids are unbeatable. They have it again. Liquid water and cracks expands when it freezes.
Nicely done. All right. And then our last question for today. Deltas are caused by what? Weathering, erosion, or deposition? So thinking about a delta, which is probably a word you don't use very much. A delta is a letter of the Greek alphabet.
Ooh, it's also the name of our pet bearded dragon.
That's right.
But that is not what we're referring to here. Here we're referring to something that is formed by a river. What do you think about this, Kaladin? It is noisy.
Was that a hint?
There's just a teeny.
No, one. Okay. That was a fair hint. All right.
We're gonna finish and reveal.
And the answer is deposition.
Deposition.
Yeah, so the sediment is being deposited at the end of the river. So you might have heard like the Nile River has a very famous delta, very fertile area where all that sediment has been deposited from the river.
That is correct. So nicely done. Unbeatable science kids have done it again. We're going to celebrate with the Russian squat dance. Go ahead and dance along with Math Dad if you'd like. And I have to say, oh my goodness, you guys, thank you for sticking with us for this lesson that has been so incredibly noisy. We're going to have one more dance just for fun, and then we're gonna call it a day.
Oh.
We did show these at the beginning. Did you wanna say something about the sugar cubes?
We didn't show them to the camera. They're part of the video, but we had a lot of fun with the sugar cube experiment. So we took sugar cubes and just shook them up, and it rounded the edges.
So much, it's really impressive. So I'd encourage you to try this if you want a simple experiment with weathering. And then of course you can use the sugar afterwards. You don't need to throw it away because it's still perfectly good sugar sphere here, and then all of the powder in your cup is still perfectly usable as well.
Yeah. So yeah, by all means, try that. We were pleasantly surprised by how round the pieces got, and yeah, you're really seeing the erosion process, all the deposition, the little sugar bits that ended up at the bottom of the cup.
Exactly. And I'm seeing several requests to feed Matt that I don't think he wants to eat just a plain sugar sphere. But he's welcome to if he does. We'll end with a quick chicken worm. Thank you so much for your patience with this crazy construction project and how loud it was. Oh my goodness.
All right, try a worm.
We hope that you will work hard and grow smarter today and just roll with the punches, because sometimes things work out as planned and sometimes they don't. And that's just part of life.